Well, welcome back to the Steve Robb Show. Today, we're talking power inverters. I got two of them, and one's a 300 watt, and the other one is a 600 watt, and they're called Pyle Road Power. Are they good pile or a pile of crap? I don't know. We're going to see. I don't put any inverter into service until I actually put it through its paces and see how it's designed and see how it will work. And I'm going to show you an inverter right here, the 600 watt, and I'm going to explain a couple of things that I've learned over the years that maybe some people don't know about inverters. Okay, so I got this one all hooked up here and everything. And if you take a look in the front here, you can see the two outlets here. And this one here actually does come with a USB charging port, which I thought was pretty good too. And this is a 600 watt. Now, a lot of people think you can get 600 watts out of one of these elements. Not elements, one of these outlets. And you can't. Not the ones that I've looked at so far. Maybe the higher end ones, I'm not too sure, but usually they're split between the both of them. And like most inverters, you have to read the specs on it and see what it's all about. But generally, a lot of them will actually surge twice as much. So out of one outlet, yeah, you might get 600 watts, but generally 300 is the max, and you're lucky to get that. A lot of times, I would not run any inverter at its max anytime. So whenever I'm looking at an inverter, I always work backwards. I start at the wattage. How many watts am I going to need? And I get an inverter twice as big. And that's what I've been doing, because guys, a lot of times these are low cost inverters like this one here. You're not going to believe what I paid for these. I'll put a link in the back there for how much I paid. You're not going to believe how much I paid for these, like almost nothing. And so that's what I like to do. You got to run everything by wattage, and that's the best thing to do. And to figure it all out, wattage is a universal form. You just divide it by your voltage and you see how many amps you have. But if you run by wattage, you can't go wrong, and get an inverter half the size of the wattage you're going to need, and it'll last you a long time. You can't push these things to the max, I'll tell you that right now. But I'm going to do some testing on these, and I have found some strange things that goes on with inverters. I'll just show you something. Here's my charge cord for my Samsung phone, and just a regular charge cord for your cell phone. Guys, this works flawlessly. But this year up at my camp, I changed all my light bulbs to these ones here. These are the new LED bulbs, and this one here is 9.5 watts, and it's equivalent to a 60 watt bulb. But guess what happened? I put them all in, and I did not have this one. This is the Samsung original charger. I had an aftermarket charger, and I put the bulbs all in, and I didn't realize I had my phone plugged in charging, and all the lights just flickering like this, just a fast flicker. And you got a feedback from my inverter through this back to the bulbs. And one of my buddies up there noticed. He said, hold on a second, let's turn the switch off for your charge controller and for this. And guess what? The flickering went away. So depending on what kind of inverter you get, you know, these are kind of a little bit of variables, and I would not use any cheap inverter to power something that's worth a lot of money, because you know, it's just not worth it. I've seen a friend of mine bring up his laptop and run a 30-foot cord. I wasn't even in the cabin at the time. Run a 30-foot cord to his laptop, and all we come in, all we smelt was burning wire. So yeah, be careful what you're doing with inverters. So let's get to doing some testing here, and I'll show you some stuff about inverters maybe you don't know. Okay, before we get started here, guys, the manual on these things here, I realize that English is not their first language in China, but some of this stuff, let me just see if I can sneak that in there. You see on the, guys, this manual is not the best I've ever seen. And but you go in the back and the specs. And the specs are the same for all these different models. And I always like to test the specs. Now it's saying here the voltage output is 100 to 120 volts. Guys, no, if you've got something running at 100 volts, I don't like that. Frequency 50 to 60, depending on what country you come from. Over in Europe it's 50 cycles, over here it's 60. And I always measure in hertz. Okay, waveform is modified sine wave, 10 volts to 15 volts. So as your voltage gets lower, your amperage will increase. What else we got here? Under voltage alarm, 10.4 to 11 volts. That just lets you know that your battery's getting too low. And off pressure, this is what they call off pressure. I guess it's gonna shut down at 9.7 to 10.3 volts. And that's, your battery's pretty well done then anyways. But, okay, shut down over voltage. So it does have, if you have too much voltage, around 14.5 to 15.5, it will shut off. No load consumption on 12 volts. So when you've got it hooked up to your battery, how much power is it drawing? And guys, the ones that I have and I've only ever used, the fan never runs. Only till you come up to a certain amount of wattage, and then it detects that it needs to have the fan on to cool it down, because these things generate heat. These two units here, they have the fan on all the time. And so I did test the small one, and it's within specs. It's saying here 0.3 amps, right? And it's within specs. But I'm going to test the big one for you and show you how far they're out. Now you have to actually do some testing, because I'm not going to throw this stuff up anywhere, you know, because I'm using these two for a project, and I don't want to put them in anywhere where, you know, something could go wrong. So I like to test them all first and put them through a little bit of a paces and see how they go. So let's do some testing here and see how these ones fare. Okay, I want to show you something first. What I've done, guys, is I've set up a cord, just like, looks like a regular extension cord, except it's been cut. So I have the two pieces here in series with my meter, and of course the end will go into the inverter. Now I don't recommend you do this at home, you know, you have to practice a little bit of safety, but I'm just going to show you what I'm doing so you can get a reading on the meter here what the amperage is when I turn on the inverter. So I'll get that all set up, and I'll place these so that they can't get tangled up or anything, and then we'll just start testing. Okay, so what do we got for testing here? This is your battery voltage right here, showing 12.7. This is the hertz right here. And this is going to be your amperage right here. So I'll turn the unit on, and it is quite loud. And right here I've got a light bulb. It's a 100 watt bulb. And we're going to watch what happens. But it is quite loud. So I mean, if you couldn't have this like inside your cabin or something like that, it would probably drive you squirrely. So this is why I like the ones that don't have the fan running all the time. I would prefer something else, but in my situation, it doesn't really matter to me. But yeah, this is quite loud. Listen to this. And this is with not anything on. Now that is pretty loud. For me, I don't know how loud it's going to sound for you. But so here we got 59 hertz. So that's pretty close to 60. And we've got no amperage at all. The battery's at 12.9. And let's turn on this lamp and see what happens. Now you can see it's still 59. Not even an amp of draw. So that's pretty good. And I really can't see anything wrong with that. Seems to work fine. Like I said before, you can only expect 150 watts out of each side with a momentary 300 watt maximum. And then it should shut down, and some of the real, real cheap ones will blow your internal fuse, and you're gonna have to take this thing apart and figure out where the fuse is. So we'll see what kind of fuse this has. I'll set up another test with a soldering gun, and that'll be a good test. So I'll just substitute the lamp that we have here, and let's go with a soldering gun next. Okay, so here's the soldering gun, and if you take a look at it there, you can see the wattage on it. And all these soldering guns, this is 230 and 150 watts, so it's a dual stage. And as it heats up, well, the amperage drops. But we'll take a look at this one here. And I believe 230 is too much for this in one outlet. So let's take a look and let's see how this runs. So we'll turn it on here. So we got the Hertz. Guys, I really like looking at Hertz more than volts. Now, the voltage on this actually is relative to the Hertz, kind of. But I really don't like to see the Hertz drop too much. We can test with the voltage on the next one and you can see the difference. But so let's just pull the trigger on this and see how many amps we get out of this. Okay, so the light's on. Can you see the light's on? And the Hertz is still up there, 59 Hertz. And we got, say, 1.1, 1.2 amps. So let's try this again, and I'll just show you on the volts. Now, the voltage coming right out of the port right now is 132.6. And let's see how far it drops. If you see it drop down to 110, guys, get rid of it. You know, it, like they're saying a minimum of 100. Well, I don't know what you're going to run off 100. You, most stuff that I see is plus or minus 10%. So let's just fire this up again. And 1.6. So we got 116 volts and maybe 1.04 amps. You know, the light's still on. So let's see if we pull the trigger all the way. See, guys? Shuts off. Shuts off. Now, the fan didn't stop. The machine didn't stop. It went into overload. And that's a good sign. I think it's all right. I really can't see any problem. Now, most of the inverters that I look at do not have that high of a voltage. 131 is quite a bit, you know. So we'll just make sure that it still works and everything. There, light's on. 1.2 amps, 116 volts. Guys, I like this inverter. It seems to be fine for me. I really can't see anything wrong with it. So let's test the 600 watt one. Okay, here's the 600 watt inverter. We'll just turn it on. And you can hear that. It's not as loud as the other one, but of course it's got the fan running as well. And 131 volts. And the battery's 13.3. So let's just do the same as before. We got this on. Down to 119. Now you notice it didn't drop very much. 119 is excellent. 119, 118, that's excellent. But of course you haven't got much of a load on it. The more load, it will drop the voltage and your amperage will go up. So let's see what this will do on full max, where the other one just shut off. This one here should be fine. 230 watts should be fine because this is a 600 watt. And so it's 300 aside, and this is 230, so this should handle it no problem. So let's just pull the trigger on this one here, and let's see how she goes. That's full speed right there. And we're seeing up to 2.4 amps, down to 116. And it's running pretty good. No complaints. My voltage on the battery is down to 12 volts. Let off on the trigger. There. I think that's pretty good. I'm liking these units for the money I paid. You're not going to believe how much I paid for these. But, yeah, I'm liking it. The only thing I want to show you now is this here is supposed to run at 0.3 of an amp, just on idle. And let's take a look at that next. Okay, so here we are. I've got my power lead from the back here on the negative side in series with the meter. And let's just fire this up. It's supposed to be 0.3 of an amp just on idle, which means there's no load on the circuit. It's just on. And the first one I did test, and it was bang on 0.3. So let's take a look at this one, and this will be the voltage coming out the end. So here's the voltage here. Here's the amperage. Guys, I'm seeing 0.6. It'll go down a little bit, but even still, that's twice as much as they've rated. So you're going to end up with about a half an amp draw on this for every hour you have this inverter running. And mainly because it's that fan, and it's not very efficient. This is not a very efficient inverter, but for its needs, I don't think it's bad at all. So, looks like around 0.57, 0.56 it'll drop down to. But it's, I tested this already, and it won't go down below 0.5. So it is higher than what it's rates at. But I still think it's a half decent power inverter for the money. Well, I hope you like this little bit of an experiment. And you know what, guys, you only get paid, you only get what you pay for. And for me, I think I got more than what I paid for. Take a look at the end, you're not gonna believe it. But I'll show you the, remember this unit here I just built? All I did is had an old pair of rubber gloves, and I just put a little flap over the top here, and that's all I did to that. But hopefully this here will not cause a problem with my LED lights on the ceiling compared to a lot of the other phone chargers, because not everybody has a factory phone charger. And yeah, they do affect the lights big time, especially when they're low quality aftermarket phone chargers. This one I've got here, I hope it's a good one. I'm gonna plug it in and we'll test it this fall, and we'll see if it affects the LED lights. But I hope you like testing some of this stuff, and I'm gonna show you some of these projects as we go on and what I'm gonna use these two inverters for. So thanks for dropping in, subscribe if you haven't, and come back, let's have some more fun. Cheers, guys.